So hello everyone and welcome back once again to the session of government schemes. In this session guys, we are going to discuss about the recently launched scheme jiska naam hai Remission of Duties and Taxes on Exported Products, or in short we can say RoDTEP. Alright, so let's begin with the session guys, and let us first try to simplify the objective of the scheme. What is the objective? So what is the name? Let us first write down the name here: Remission of Duties and Taxes on Exported Products. Alright, so this is the name of the scheme, and remember this was launched in the year 2020 very recently, and it has been implemented starting from 1st January 2021. Okay, so there are few keywords here through which we can easily determine the objective. So the remission of duties and taxes means the government wants to reduce the taxes and duties, okay, on what? On the exported products. And remember, this is for the exported goods only. Okay, this is for the exported goods only. This is not for the services. All right. And if you remember, there was a scheme which is known as Merchandise Export Incentive Scheme. Okay, MEIS. So this scheme will replace this scheme, MEIS. Okay, so RoDTEP will replace Merchandise Export Incentive Scheme. All right. And through this scheme, government wants to reduce the taxes and duties on the exported products, thereby इम्प्रूविंग द एक्सपोर्टर्स, यू नो, जो एक्सपोर्टर्स हैं उनके हालात को इम्प्रूव करने के लिए, उनके जो एक्सपोर्ट हैं उनको बढ़ाने के लिए दिस स्कीम हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड बाय द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया थ्रू द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ कॉमर्स एंड इंडस्ट्री. ऑलराइट, सो आई होप गाइस द ऑब्जेक्टिव इज क्लियर, एंड दीज आर द ऑब्जेक्टिव्स इन डिटेल: टू बूस्ट एक्सपोर्ट्स बाय रिड्यूसिंग ड्यूटीज ऑन एक्सपोर्ट्स, एंड टू प्रोवाइड इजी रिफंड ऑफ वेरियस टैक्सेस टू द एक्सपोर्टर्स. जो भी उनके टैक्सेस लगते थे, इससे पहले कुछ टैक्सेस ऐसे हुआ करते थे सेंटर के और स्टेट के जिनका रिफंड नहीं दिया जाता था. देर वॉर सम टैक्सेस ऑफ विच रिफंड वॉज नॉट प्रोवाइडेड टू द एक्सपोर्टर्स, बट नाउ थ्रू दिस स्कीम दोज रिफंड विल ऑल्सो बी प्रोवाइडेड टू द एक्सपोर्टर्स. राइट, फॉर एग्जाम्पल, वैट ऑन फ्यूल यूज इन ट्रांसपोर्टेशन, ड्यूटी ऑन द इलेक्ट्रिसिटी मैन्युफैक्चरिंग एटसेट्रा. एंड टू प्रोवाइड ऑटोमेटिक रिफंड रूट फॉर द इनपुट टैक्स क्रेडिट इज ऑल्सो वन ऑफ द यू नो ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ दिस स्कीम. नाउ वट इज दिस इनपुट टैक्स क्रेडिट? So it, guys, basically it is provided to set off the taxes paid on the purchase of raw materials, consumable goods or services, thus help in reducing the cascading effect. Basically क्या है कि मान लो कि manufacturer है, उसने 50 रुपए GST भरा, ठीक है, and the GST on the consumer it is 100. So ये जो 100 rupees है उसमें से 50 rupees क्या हो जाएंगे, adjust हो जाएंगे, उसको वो 50 rupees कम GST भरना पड़ेगा. So this is, अगर वो उसमें जुड़ जाता है तो total GST कितना होता, 150. If this rupees 50 is added to this 100, then the total GST would be how much? 150. So the final consumer would have to pay how much? 150 as the GST. But since this 50 has been deposited by the manufacturer already, so now the consumer has to pay only 100 rupees as the GST. All right. So this is the cascading effect. And to reduce this cascading effect, input tax credit naam ka ek funda hota hai. And this input tax credit ke through automatic refund will be provided through this scheme RoDTEP. Alright. And to help exporters in meeting the international export standards, thereby achieving the export targets of the government of India. Alright. So I hope guys the objective is clear. And as I told you, the ministry is the Ministry of Commerce and Industry. And who is the minister currently? It's Mr. Piyush Goyal, when I am recording this video in the month of January 2021. But before exam, you have to confirm about the name of the minister. Launch year, as I told you, it was launched very recently in the year 2020, and it was implemented since 1st January 2021. Okay, so I hope guys ये सारी चीजें तो याद रखने की जरूरत नहीं पड़नी चाहिए. Objective इसके नाम से ही क्लियर हो रहा है, remission of duties and taxes on exported products. बस yes, अगर एग्जाम में शॉर्ट फॉर्म लिखी हुई आ गई, then you should remember the full form. RoDTEP का फुल फॉर्म you have to remember, remission of duties and taxes on exported products. Then only you can easily identify the objective. Ministry, of course, since we are talking about the exported products, which means we are talking about the exports. And Ministry of Commerce and Industry is there to deal with the exports in our country. So the implementing ministry is Ministry of Commerce and Industry. And the launch year, we all know, is the 2020. Okay. Now, talking about the eligibility. So the scheme guys will include all the sectors with priority given to the labor intensive sectors. Priority jo hai wo kisko di jayegi? लेबर इंटेंसिव सेक्टर्स को, और इसमें सारे सेक्टर्स इंक्लूड हैं. रिमेंबर, सर्विसेज आर नॉट इंक्लूडेड, ओनली इट इज फॉर द एक्सपोर्टेड गुड्स. ऑलराइट, एंड देयर इज नो मिनिमम टर्नओवर क्राइटेरिया, व्हिच इज वेरी गुड थिंग अबाउट द स्कीम. देयर इज नो मिनिमम टर्नओवर क्राइटेरिया, goods exported through e-commerce platform are also eligible to get the benefits. जो e-commerce platform के through अगर कोई good export हुआ है, then that is also eligible, right? And the country of origin of the exported product or the good should be India. जो re-exported products होंगे वो include नहीं होंगे. मान लो कि कोई product है, कोई product है that comes from Malaysia to India. Let us say this is Malaysia, this is India, and this is USA. Alright, this is USA. So if any product comes from Malaysia to India and then from India it is exported to USA, then that product is not provided benefit under this RoDTEP scheme. The country of origin should be India. Alright. And moving ahead to the process of refund, so yaad rakhne ki zarurat nahi hai itna zyada. Just remember about the eligibility mein bhi yaad rakhne ki zarurat nahi hai. All the categories under the export goods are included. Just remember that there is no minimum turnover criteria and the country of origin should be our pyara Bharat. Alright. And process of refund to bilkul simple hai. Central, state, local duties or taxes will be refunded retrospectively in the ledger account of the exporters. Alright, baki cheeze humare kaam ki nahi hai. That is not important for the exam. You can just have a read. Okay. So guys, this was about the scheme and talking about the rates. Agar hum rates ki baat karein, so kis rate per refund milega? What will be the rates of refunds that will be provided to the exporter? So let me tell you. Till 29th January 2021, when I am recording this video, the rates are not announced by the ministry, but iske liye committee bana di gayi hai, headed by G.K. Pillai. Alright, there is a committee. Based on this committee's recommendation, the rates of refunds will be decided in the near future. Okay, so remember the name of this committee also, G.K. Pillai committee. Alright, and now guys, let's move on to the question. So I hope guys, this scheme is clear. So let's once more revise it. So as the name suggests, remission of duties and taxes. So the government wants to reduce the taxes and duties on the exported goods, and mark my words, it is only for goods, not for services. And through this, government wants to increase the exports, and through which we will also be able to achieve the export targets. Ministry is the Ministry of Commerce and Industry. Launch year 2020, implementing date 1st January 2021. All the sectors are included with priority given to the labor intensive sector. There is no minimum criteria for turnover. The country of origin of the exported product should be India. Alright. And e-commerce platform wale jo products honge, that are also eligible. Process of refund is not important for the exam. Alright. So now guys, let's discuss this question that can be asked in your exam from this RoDTEP. So you have to consider the following statements regarding the scheme and identify the correct statements. You have to identify the correct statements here. It was launched on 1st January 2021. So is it correct? It was launched on 1st January? No. It was launched in the year 2020, but it has been implemented from 1st January 2021. So there is a difference between launch year and the implementation year. Okay. So this statement is incorrect. The scheme has replaced the merchandise export incentive scheme. This is absolutely correct. And for deciding the rates under which the refunds can be availed, G.K. Pillai committee was formed. So as I told you, there is one committee headed by Mr. G.K. Pillai. This committee has been formed to provide the recommendations regarding the rates of refund. Okay, so this statement is correct. Second and third statements are correct, and we have to identify the correct statements, which means option B, only 2 and 3 will be the correct answer. Okay. And guys, that's it for this scheme. I hope this scheme is clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.